Hello friends, I am Dr. Bhatia, Director of Dr. Bhatia Medical Institute. I welcome you all to our institute. Today I will be talking to you regarding the courses, how to study, what to study for the exams. Okay, so first thing is regarding the exams, you should know ultimately you have to write your entrance exam. Some of you might be in the undergraduate and some of you are intern or post interns. So I'll be taking care of all the exams so that anyone who is sitting in the class, everybody should be benefited. Well, first of all, we talk about the PG entrance exam, which everybody has to write. Now, what the exam is? First point is exam, PG entrance exam. PG entrance exam. Well, the main exam is always following other main exam. One is All India PG, other is DNB, AIIMS, PGI, and of course plus various state PG exams. Okay, well, in total, like this All India PG is an exam which is written by almost, and DNB exams are written by almost everyone. In this, around 1.5 lakh students, they write the exam every year. Out of these 1.5, the actual interview call comes to around 10,000 people. That means out of 1.5 lakhs, 1.4 lakhs students are rejected. Rejected. Only this much are selected and 1.4 lakhs are rejected. So if we call entrance exam as a rejecting exam, then the statement is not wrong. I repeat again, if I say the entrance exam is more of a rejecting exam, the statement is not wrong. Figures are in front of you. So if you calculate, there are 10,000 people who are competing for 1.5 lakh students, and out of these 10,000 students, the actual seats are only few. Only actual seats are hardly 3,000 to 4,000. What do you mean by actual seats? By actual seat means, if I ask you, if you top in the this exam, which branch you want, the answer will be, sir, I want radiology, medicine, surgery, OBG, pediatric, orthopedics. Okay, nobody wants anatomy, physio, biochem, but this include everything. This 10,000 include everything. So that's why the actual seats are only 3,000 to 4,000. That means if you want a good college, even if you get a good branch in a very bad college, so perhaps you will not like to go. So friends, if you want to get a good branch in a good college, you have to be among the first four or five thousand in the whole list. So in that way, if you calculate the ratio is almost 1:100 or 1:75, whatever you can say. There is one chair and 100 people are competing for that. So entrance exam is like a game of musical chair. All of us have played a game of musical chair. So there is one seat and there are 100 people are competing for that. Okay, the first point that you understand till now, the message conveyed to you is that it is a game of musical chair. The first lesson that we got it. Now, so, well, in your university exam, when you write the exam, you have to get only 50% marks. You have to get 50% marks and you go to the next prof, LLTPT in final year. When you get 50% mark, you pass the exam and immediately you become doctor, and this word is prefixed to our name, and to get this name we really struggle for 5 years. So you become doctor, you are happy, but remember, here you could do the job by getting only 50% marks, but in the entrance exam I may get 90% marks, you get 91% mark, other get 92% mark, I don't get a seat, you don't get a seat, he gets a seat because he got more marks than what we got it. So friends, in entrance exam, point number two, you should get more marks. You should get more marks than what your other friends are getting. This is the message number two. The first message was that it's a game of musical chair, and number two, you have to get more marks than what other get. That's the rule of success. Got it? So remember, PG enters is more of a rejecting exam. Now, next point I'm going to study is discuss is what mistakes we do. What are the mistakes? Mistakes. It is good to know how to get success, but it is better to know how not to fail. It is good to know how to get success, but it's better to know how not to fail. Why people fail? You'll be, so now I tell the point. You may be noticing there are many people in your colleagues or senior who are studying for 2, 3, 4, 5 years, and they write the exam every year, but still they are not able to get through. Why? So let's learn why they fail. Okay? Friends, in any exam, around 20% questions can be done by everybody. If I give you the paper of next year, you can get 20% marks right now. 10% nobody knows. 20 are done by an average person. The whole game is of this 50%. Now what are these 50%? Now what happened? When you read, you keep on reading same thing again. When you read, you keep on reading same thing again. Remember, 20 are done by everybody, 20 by every person, 10% nobody knows, and 50%, these are the ones which play the major role in the selection. So when you read, you keep on reading same thing again. What you don't know, you never read. Now those of my colleagues who are in final year or interns or post-intern, I can tell you right now what you don't know. Most of you are not comfortable with ECG. Am I right? If I give you ECG in your hand, it comes to we have some teddy-meddy Japanese or Chinese language. Arrhythmias, most of us are not very comfortable with arrhythmias. Most of us, we don't know acid, base disturbance. You don't know renal tubular acidosis. You don't know the stroke syndrome like Miller-Gubler syndrome, Benedict syndrome in the brain, we don't know. So this is a list, long list is there, which you don't read. And this constitute what the 50% is. This all constitute these 50% questions, what I was talking to you. Okay? And now you'll be surprised to know, how do you know all these things? You are bound to ask me question, are you an astrologer? Aap ek jyotishi hain? No. I'm not an astrologer. Friends, about 17, 18 years back, there were no such institute for PG entrance. I was the first person who conceived the idea of PG entrance in India. In that way, I am the founder of all these courses in India. Till date, I have taught more than 1.25 lakh students. I have taught more than 1.25 lakh students all over India. I have been to many outside country also. So friends, these topics are not known to what list, is not known to anybody in the whole country. Most of people in the whole country, people are not comfortable with this topic. Most of students. Vague ideas are there, but not that firm grip where we are very confident, yes, I know this topic very well. So these topics are not read by anybody in the whole country. So they are your grey areas, we know it very well. So they constitute this 50%. So when we teach you, our focus is mainly on this particular aspect. We focus on this particular aspect is our main area where we have to, because we know very well, to get a seat, you should know more than what other get. That's the tagline to get a PG entrance. So our main aim is to focus on this 60% aspect. Like when we will teach you, we will not teach you that in tuberculosis there is fever, hemoptysis, weight loss, that you know, everybody knows. We will not tell you that in case of cholera there is rice, water, stool is there, watery stool is there, vomiting occurs. We will not teach you. That's too simple to talk to this illustrious batch. But we will talk to you those topics which I have discussed, which are your gray areas, so that ultimate aim is you should know more than what others know it. So friends, so what we learned now, that we have to focus on this area, which are our grey areas. Now what we do for you, like I give you an example. This is the road full of gaddas or holes or potholes are there. Even if you have a very nice car, you have a Mercedes car with you, you cannot drive more than 20 km per hour. Your speed in this will be 20 km per hour. Why? The road is badly damaged. Now somebody comes and makes a nice road, like a beautiful highway. If we fill all these gaps and we make a international road, your speed will go to 120 km per hour. Your speed will become 120. Same car, same driver, but speed has gone from 20 to 120 because road has become excellent. Friends, we know what are your weak points. We know all your weak points, and we are going to make a beautiful road for you so that you can drive the road very fast. You can drive the same vehicle with a very fast speed, so we will fill up all your gaps. Okay, so now you understood what mistake we do and what correction we are going to do it. Right? Now, so next point. I hope you have read today's newspaper. No? Well, in today's newspaper, a very famous astrologer has given the name and the photograph of the person who will be topping in all the exams in the coming years. You want to know the name? Yes? No? Yeah. Those who want to know the name of the person who will top in the exams, coming exams, I have got the name and the photograph. And I am very happy to inform that person is sitting right now in the classroom. Right now in front of me the person is sitting. You want to know the name of the person? Raise the hand. Yeah. The name of the person is I. Yeah, yeah. Do it. I. Hey, don't laugh. Oh, I can see many people have not done it. Please. Who will top in the exam? Answer is I. those who will not do, those who are not doing, they will get second rank. You want to get second rank? No, no. So please do it. Yeah. So who will top? Answer is I. Yes, you are the best. Friends, you are the best. Life is a Mahabharat. To win this Mahabharat, the first thing is self-confidence. If you don't have self-confidence, you can never win this war. In actual also, when the Mahabharat happened, thousands of years back, before the war, Arjuna said, I will do this, I will do that. But when he reached the battlefield of Kurukshetra, he saw the army of the opponent, he lost confidence and he kept his bow and arrow, I can't fight. What was that? That was simple loss of self-confidence. Okay? So, Lord Krishna simply motivated him to fight. You read the whole Bhagavad Gita. The summary of the Bhagavad Gita is, Lord Krishna told Arjuna, you are a soldier. Every country has an army. And the duty of an army man is to fight the enemy. He has not to get nervous in the battlefield. This is true. Today also it's true. Those who are saving our jawans or soldiers in the battlefield, they are supposed to fight during the time of war. Same thing what Lord Krishna told Arjuna also. And simple, he gave him guidance. He motivated him to do his duty. Because everybody has some duty to perform in this earth. A duty of a soldier is to fight. So he simply motivated to him is to give the right direction, right pathway. So there can't be any better person than Lord Krishna as a motivator. So friends, so Lord Krishna told Arjuna that you are the best fighter. He is the best Dhanvar archer in the world. Same thing, you are the best. Right? So who is the best, who will top in the exam? Answer is I. You are the topper. I is the name of topper. You will get success. You have to. You are our Arjunas. Now the next point is, suppose I say you want to top in all the exams, whichever exam, whether you write your university exam, those who are undergraduate, and those interns who are post-intern who are going to write PG entrance, how many hours a day you should study? If I ask this question, usual answer is 10 hours, 12 hours, 14 hours, 15 hours, 20 hours. At one place I was taking lecture, I asked this question, the answer came that we should study 25 hours per day. Well, it's a democratic country, anybody can answer. It was really fun to know that 25 hours, well, it's a democratic country, anybody can answer. Okay. Well, if you ask the answer is, you have to read only 1 hour per day. 1 hour per day only. This is point number four. 1 hour per day. Sir, are you joking? Have you called us to crack a joke with us? No, I am very serious. You have to read only 1 hour per day. Don't believe it? Don't worry. In a couple of minutes only, I'll prove it that 1 hour is good enough to study. Look, there is no shortcut to hard work. But hard work should be done in a smart way. Smart work is more important than hard work. So friends, write down. Smart work is more important than hard work. Hard work. But do not forget, there is no shortcut to hard work. But hard work should be done in a smart way. Okay? It is not the speed. We determine the destination, but the right direction. I repeat again. It is not the speed. We determine the destination, but the right direction. right direction. And what is this? This I am going to prove it in a couple of minutes only. Right, sir? So first of all, I'll tell you how to study. How to study 1 hour per day, smart, what the meaning? First, I'll explain to you. Then I'll tell you how to study, how to remember only for 1 hour per day. So friends, out of the different topics, what we got it, ECG, arrhythmias, acid base. So I'll teach you ECG. I'll teach you ECG. Now, if I ask you that if you have to read ECG, I'm going to take a test of ECG, how much time you need, how many days you need. Well, people say I need about 5 to 7 days and I'll be reading for 10 hours per day. So you need 70 hours to read ECG. I will teach you ECG in around 20 or 25 minutes and you will revise in less than 3 minutes. You will revise in less than 3 minutes. So in the under 20-25 minutes, I'll make a master of ECG to you. Then I'll tell you ki how to read all these things. Then I'll again come back to this slide. So let's talk about the